我们继续来关注一下加州州长的竞选内容。来看本网洛杉矶华人资讯网在8月19号记者 Tracy 的独家采访，距离罢免加州州长特别选举呢，还有将近一个月的时间。备受瞩目的州长候选人之一，现年36岁的共和党籍候选人凯文·凯利接受了本网记者的专访，和 Tracy 一起分享了其竞选的政见。那么记者呢，也是就华裔、亚裔最关心的议题和凯利进行了充分的讨论。凯利向 Tracy 表示，纽森必须要被罢免，因为呢，在疫情期间他滥用了公众信任，并且使用紧急特权谋取个人政治利益。凯利同时也表示，目前竞选阶段已经进入到白热化，这次的竞选也让加州在很大程度上可以重现光辉。记者问到说，针对于亚裔的仇恨犯罪在加州已经成为一个非常严重的问题了，特别是在北加州，例如旧金山、奥克兰等城市，那么你有什么策略来减少或者是消除加州内的仇恨犯罪呢？他说，我会努力撤销加州多年以来出台的有害政策，致力于打击一切的犯罪。我将全力支持警察的执法工作，以及完善司法体系，在保障民众安全方面所扮演至关重要的角色。加州公共政策研究所最新的一份报告显示，去年的凶杀案增加了 30.3%， 这是自从1960年开始持续记录以来的最大单年增幅。但是与此同时，加州仍然继续以紧急情况作为幌子，提前的释放囚犯。而对于华裔都比较反对的 Prop 47号的主张，也就是轻罪化的这个提案哈，凯利说，如果自己上任的话，将会推翻这一个提案。我们一起来看一段视频。
Okay, and actually, what's your opinion on Proposition 47? Would you consider overturn Proposition 47?
Yes, I would want to overturn Proposition 47. It's proven to be a disaster for public safety and has led to an epidemic of retail theft, where you can essentially steal up to $950 without there being any real consequence. That's not the way things should work. It's made it so a lot of retailers can't even operate in certain communities. It's made it so our police officers aren't able to do their jobs, and it's taken away their power to detain people who are committing serious offenses. So I absolutely would want to overturn Prop 47. It's also led to open drug use on our streets by making possession of Class A drugs, even cocaine and heroin, into simply a misdemeanor for which you could only be given a minor infraction.
那么在其他华裔民众都关心的话题上，例如毒品的注射站，凯利表示自己非常反对。他不认为加州需要合法的毒品注射站，他认为加州民众需要的是安全和健康，而非毒品。同时，毒品注射站会在青少年之间产生潜移默化的不良影响，或者是导致出现不良风气。教育也是华裔民众最关心的话题之一。凯利认为，种族和肤色不应该成为大学招生的考虑优先因素，择优而录才是目前最理想的大学招生方式。他举例称，16号提案已经被否决，它是有一定道理的。被否决已经证明了加州选民的意愿。我们来看一段视频。
Another issue is the admission in college. How do you see the college consider the race?In college admission.
Everyone should be judged based upon their merit. And the voters of California feel the same way. Gavin Newsom supported an effort to overturn the protections of equality under law in this last election. And, the voters said no. We believe that, people should be judged not by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. And so we want to have equality under law.
另外，和所有的共和党竞选人一样，凯利称如果自己上任，将会结束加州因为新冠疫情而进入到的紧急状态，并且撤销口罩令。那么其实呢，现在疫情并未开始回暖。那么针对于这一问题，他表示，民众有自由选择的权利，是否要佩戴口罩，不应该由政府强制来规定。另外，他举例说，欧洲和英国都建议12岁以下的学生无需佩戴口罩，他希望可以为加州人民服务，但是不会掌控他们的生活和自主决策权。我们来看一段视频。
Most of Europe hasn't had mask mandates for kids under the age of 12. The United Kingdom has decided that they're not going to have a mask mandate for kids in elementary schools because they say that the harms to the development of kids far outweigh any benefits that might come from wearing a mask. I absolutely believe that you should be able to, but it should be a choice that's up to parents, whether or not this is something that is right for their child. It shouldn't be up to the governor to simply make this decision for millions of families across the state.
凯利的竞选政见包括上任第一天结束加州的疫情紧急状态，撤销口罩令，允许学校资金更为优化，将学校资金落实在学生身上，将洛杉矶联合学区划为更小的学区，反对学校教授批判性种族理论，取消限制联邦移民官员与当地执法部门合作的庇护州的称号，将加州医保的福利扩大到无证移群，利用行政命令撤销对企业有限制的机构规定，通过更多的庇护所和治疗来解决加州内的无家可归者问题，并且对加州所有的资金和项目进行新一轮的审计，从把资金呢从高铁的项目转向高速公路、桥梁、水库和堤坝和发电厂。那么凯利呢是来自罗克林，他自2017年担任了州议员，那么他曾经也是地检官和高中英语老师，他也曾经因为起诉纽森关于新冠疫情的这个行政令的而登上新闻头条，在当地比较具有知名度。